The kidneys. They're some complicated little organs. And as a result, kidney disease can be very complicated to both understand and to treat. Let's talk about it. Hello everyone, Dr. Rhett here, and today is the first real cold snap of the season. So I figured I would take this episode outside because it's so beautiful. So you'll have to excuse me if you hear some extraneous sounds. Kidney disease can be a really complicated subject, and it can take a really long time to go through every single problem that can involve the kidneys. So I figured I'd do another series like I did with food. That seemed to turn out well, and it's gonna allow me to talk more about the kidneys and kidney disease without hitting you with a ton of information all at once. Today's episode is primarily gonna concentrate on chronic kidney disease or chronic renal disease or chronic kidney failure. All of those terms are pretty much interchangeable, but the basic idea of this particular disease is long-term progressive changes to the kidneys that eventually lead to the kidneys failing. This is a disease that primarily affects older patients. Go get them. My dogs are really happy with this weather right now. Now, other than the obvious task of urination and eliminating wastes from our body, the kidneys do a lot of other things that you may not be aware of. They play a very important role in the production of red blood cells. They also constantly work to maintain blood pressure. Now, I'm not going to get too deep into the physiology of the kidneys because they're so complicated that people dedicate their entire lives to renal physiology. But those other tasks that I mentioned come into play when you're talking about chronic kidney disease. The first clinical sign that you may notice with chronic kidney disease is that you may find that your pet is drinking and urinating more than usual. The reason why this excessive drinking and urination occurs is because the kidneys are starting to lose their ability to retain water when needed. This is an important process not only in making sure that we don't get dehydrated, but also in maintaining blood pressure. If an owner brings a patient in and mentions that they seem to be drinking and peeing more, one of the first things that we're going to recommend is blood work and a urinalysis. The blood work allows us to look at the kidney values to see if they're getting elevated. And the urinalysis is twofold. First, it allows us to rule out a urinary tract infection, which could be contributing to the drinking and the urination. But it also allows us to further evaluate the kidney function. If you've ever noticed when you go a long time without drinking and you may be a little bit dehydrated, whenever you urinate, your urine tends to be very dark and concentrated. If a patient has kidney disease, they start to lose that ability to concentrate the urine. So their kidney values may be up, which could indicate kidney disease, or it could just mean the patient is slightly dehydrated. But if the kidney values are elevated and the urine is dilute rather than concentrated, that means that the kidneys are starting to lose a little bit of function, which further suggests kidney disease. I just realized I'm probably making people motion sick by doing all that walking around, so I decided to put the camera on a tripod. As the chronic kidney disease progresses, other clinical signs will start to occur. The patient can lose their appetite and become anorectic. They can start vomiting intermittently. They can start losing weight and muscle mass. Once the chronic kidney disease reaches a certain point, the kidneys lose their ability to do the other jobs that they do. They'll eventually stop producing a chemical called erythropoietin. This is a very important chemical that the body uses as a signal to make red blood cells. So as the kidneys lose this function, the patient can become anemic. Believe it or not, kidney disease can actually lead to blindness as well. Because the kidneys play such an important role in maintaining blood pressure, the patient eventually loses their ability to regulate that blood pressure, and they can become dangerously hypertensive, which means that their blood pressure is constantly very high. This eventually can cause a retinal detachment in the eye, which leads to blindness. As the patient approaches end-stage kidney disease, they end up developing a syndrome called uremia, or uremic syndrome. This can cause them to act tired, disassociated, they can vomit often, and they can even develop horrible smelling breath as well as ulcers in the mouth. This is usually an indicator that they're very far along in the disease and they probably don't have much time left. So what exactly can be done about chronic kidney disease? The main thing that you have to remember about chronic kidney disease or chronic renal failure is that it's treatable but not curable. This means that the goal of your veterinarian is to put your pet on a treatment plan that's going to maximize quality of life for as long as possible, but eventually the kidney disease is going to win. If you catch the kidney disease early, usually the treatment is something as simple as putting the patient on a prescription diet and making sure that they have access to good clean water at all times. As the disease progresses and the patient starts developing other clinical signs from other kidney functions that are failing, then your veterinarian is going to start adding treatments to try and maintain those processes that the kidneys can no longer do. A lot of times, we'll train our pet's owners on how to give subcutaneous fluids at home. Animals have the benefit of having a layer of subcutaneous fat in between the skin and the muscles. So it's actually very easy to take a sterile saline solution and inject it up under the skin that the patient will eventually absorb over the following hours. This is a very helpful technique in maintaining proper hydration and fluid balance, and it can be very easily done at home if you're comfortable with it. As the kidney failure progresses, sometimes the patient has to spend a night or two in the hospital every now and then. This allows us to put an IV catheter in them and give them the fluid therapy that they need. Sometimes something as simple as a night or two in the hospital with aggressive fluid therapy and anti-nausea medications can perk them up for an extended period of time. Your veterinarian may also recommend that you switch your pet to a canned food if they're eating a dry food. The reason for this is that canned foods contain more moisture. We may eventually have to put your pet on things like blood pressure medications and/or supplements and medications that may help combat your pet's anemia. Eventually, though, all the treatments and medications in the world won't be enough. Chronic kidney disease is ultimately terminal, but that doesn't mean that we can't get a good quality of life for an extended period of time if you catch the disease early enough. On a side note, there are also some more rare disorders that can cause chronic kidney disease in younger patients. So no matter what age your pet may be, if you start to notice that they're drinking and urinating more often, make sure to take them to the veterinarian just to get it checked out. You could ultimately be catching something very serious in its early stages. So that's chronic kidney disease in a nutshell. There's actually way more to it than what I talked about in this episode, but if I went in depth, this video would probably be 5 hours long. Hopefully though, it's enough information for you to understand a little bit better. That way, if your pet has the disease, hopefully it's not so confusing. In the next few episodes of this series, I'm going to be talking about other diseases that affect the kidneys. And if you have any questions concerning kidney disease or any other pathology, please feel free to drop them in the comments. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and we'll see you in the next video. Take care.